is known to itself and to many countries as to be the land of the free, where personal liberty is paramount. Our Declaration of Independence states that all men are created equal, that they are endowed by their Creator with certain unalienable rights, but among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. With this phrase in mind, how can we justify laws that prevent same-sex couples from marrying? Marriage affords people in this country additional rights and protections under federal law, provides a better foundation for peoples of couples, and also offers a better quality of life than when unmarried. The freedom to marry the person of your choosing is undoubtedly a manifestation of liberty and pursuit of happiness. Currently, there are 11 states that allow for some sort of domestic partnership or civil union. The ability to be seen as married is necessary because other states outside of the 11 are not legally obligated to acknowledge any of the benefits that come along with being involved in that sort of partnership in those states. Partnerships granted in California are entitled to full marriage benefits from that state, but if a couple were to move to a state that does not recognize unions like North Carolina, these benefits would not be transferred. Still, this does not mean that any benefits or rights that would be given to a married heterosexual couple from the federal government, such as Medicare coverage, military benefits, or the ability to file jointly for bankruptcy, would be available to same-sex couples, as the Defense of Marriage Act defines these as a legal union between one man and one woman. There are 1,138 different federal laws whose benefits are affected by marital status, like the ones that I just listed off. This is also a discriminatory practice, as like refusing to marry interracial couples. Perhaps the most important aspect of married life, as opposed to simply living together, is the financial one. Married people pool their wealth together and have the ability to set aside more money in savings than their unmarried counterparts. According to Joseph Lipton and James Smith's paper, Marriage Assets and Savings, married couples have more than two times net worth and typically own assets 3 to 4 times larger than other groups. If a person were to become ill or lay off, having a spouse helps to ease the financial burden, either from the income from unemployment, Social Security, or by helping to take care of the ill spouse, lessening the need for constant medical supervision in the cases of people without critical conditions. The bankruptcy option available to married couples through the federal government that was briefly mentioned earlier also allows the couple and the creditors to pay the fees and claims twice. Married couples with a spouse in the military can also receive access to their spouse's health insurance and, in the event that a spouse dies, receives future retirement checks until they remarry. This is also true of Social Security. Widows also don't have to pay an estate tax. There is a woman named Edith Windsor. She was with her partner for 44 years. Her partner died and she was charged $350,000 in estate tax, and this is not a tax that a married couple would have to pay. According to the American Psychological Association, being denied the right to marry can particularly undermine the healthy development of a well-adjusted emotional and social attachment style among adolescents. In the same fact sheet, the APA goes on to refer to a study where people involved and same-sex unions are more likely to stay in a committed relationship. A poll conducted by the Williams Institute among married same-sex couples in Massachusetts found that 72% of participants felt more committed to their partner. This feeling of greater commitment, the ability to have their relationships legally recognized, and the benefits that come with marriage undoubtedly lower stress and could also lower health issues that stress can cause, such as high blood pressure and heart disease. Along with the access to health insurance, a press release by the AHRQ states that researchers found that people who are married are more likely to engage in healthy behavior, like not smoking and exercise. As you can see, marriage offers many benefits to couples. It is something that heterosexual couples may take for granted, but it is largely denied to their same-sex counterparts. While civil unions are allowed in a handful of states, it is not enough that it can be ignored or does not grant equal rights and privileges that marriages can. Marriage must be redefined under federal law, and same-sex marriage must be allowed. To do anything less is to dishonor the principle on which this country holds dear. If you are interested in contacting any of your state representatives, either on the state level or the national level, you can find out who's in charge.